Oyagala omukulu gw'enjawulo gubeere n'ebijjukizo mu nyumba yo? Kankwanjulire Backing Montage Photo Studio. Feba kafuluma okuba ebifaananyi n'okola video. Olina wedding, birthday party, kukyala, nika, baby shower, photoshoot oba music shoot. Na buli kimu kyonna ky'oyagala, ffe tusobola okuwa ebijjukizo ebirungi eri ebirooto byo. Ate nno mwana wattu kusinte ez'omuntu wa bulijjo. Tusange bannankulabi ku bitaala ku Prime Tower, Level 3, Room D04. Okumanya ebisingawo, tukubire ku nnamba zino. Noti 7, noti 2, emu noti 4, emu 2 5. Oba noti 7 5 5 satu emu emu musavu satu emu oba noti 7 musavu musavu noti 2 satu nya noti 5 King Montage Photo Studio fitu sobolo kuwa bijukize birungi ate no mwana watu kusinte ezo mtu wa bulijjo.
Welcome to Love Media, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe and activate the notification bell. Today we are going to see Busaga is a kingdom and one of four constitutional monarchies in present-day Uganda. The kingdom is a cultural institution which promotes popular participation and unity among the people of the region through development programs to improve their standard of living. Busaga strives for a united people who have economic, social, and cultural prosperity and assists the Kayabazinga. Busaga means land of the Soga, and is the kingdom of the 11 principalities of the Basoga or Soga, singular Musaga, people. Its capital is Bujumbe, near Jinja, Uganda's second largest city, after Kampala. Busaga comprises 8 districts: Kamuli, Iganga, Bujiri, Mayuj, Jinja, Luaka, and the new districts of Kaloro and Biziki. Each district is headed by an elected chairperson or a local council 5, and municipalities are headed by an elected mayor. Jinja is the industrial and economic hub of Busaga. Busaga is bordered on the north by shallow Lake Kiga, separating it from Lango, on the west by the Victoria Nile, separating it from Buganda, on the south by Lake Victoria, separating it from Tanzania and Kenya, and on the east by the Mpologoma River, separating it from smaller tribal groups such as the Adhola, Bugwara, and Bujisu. It also includes several islands in Lake Victoria, such as Bavuma Island. Busaga is ruled by the Isibantu Kayabazinga, who is currently William Kadhumbula Gabula Ndiop IV, the Gabula of Bugabula, and grandson to Wilberforce Kadhumbula Ndiop, former vice president and also Kayabazinga of Busaga Kingdom. In 1995, the government restored monarchies in Uganda in Article 246, 1. Of the Constitution of Uganda. On 11 February 1996, 1 Henry Wacko Moloki was reinstated as Kayabazinga Isibantu of Busaga. He served until September 1, 2008, when he died of esophageal cancer at the Mulago National Referral Hospital in Kampala at age 87. 1 In a condolence message, Ugandan President Yoweri Museveni described Moloki as a great cultural leader and father who was generous and kind. Museveni noted that since his reinstallation, 1 Moloki was a unifying factor in Busaga, the government has had the privilege of working with Isibantu Moloki in developing our nation. Referring to the Kayabazinga as a strong pillar, the president said that although Busaga was one of the youngest kingdoms, under Moloki's leadership it had become strong. Uganda mourns not only one of her esteemed traditional leaders but a national who put development and the welfare of the people of Busaga at the helm of his reign. Moloki's achievements included programs for youth, the elderly, and the poor, and the education of girls. Although the royal chiefs of Busaga at first elected Edward Columbus Wambuze, Moloki's son, as Kayabazinga of Busaga, the election was contested due to lack of quorum, at least 8 chiefs, and thus electing later Gabula Ndiop IV with 10 out of 11 chiefs, and was crowned on September 13, 2014. Busaga's written history began in 1862. On July 28, Royal Geographical Society explorer John Hanning Speck arrived at Ripon Falls, near Jinja, where the Victoria Nile flows from Lake Victoria and begins its descent to Egypt. Since Speck's route, inland from the East African coast, took him around the southern end of Lake Victoria, he approached Busaga from the west, through Buganda. Having reached his goal, the source of the Nile, he turned northward and followed the river downstream without exploring Busaga. He records, however, being told that Busaga, Swahili for Busaga, was an island. It is bordered on all 4 sides by water. During the 19th century, one of the main routes along which Europeans traveled from the coast to Buganda passed through southern Busaga. Speck, James Grant, Gerald Portal, Frederick Lugard, J.R. MacDonald and Bishop Tuckett noted that Busaga had plentiful food and was densely populated. However, between 1898-99 and 1900-01 the first cases of sleeping sickness were reported. In 1906, orders were issued to evacuate the region. Despite attempts to clear the area, the epidemic continued until 1910. As a result, most of the densely populated parts of Busaga, with an original population of over 200,000, were depopulated within 10 years. Lubis Palace at Bukalba and the European Fruit Mission collapsed, and survivors were relocated to other parts of Busaga. Southern Busaga, about one-third of the kingdom's area, was depopulated by 1910. During the 1920s and 1930s, some evacuees who survived the epidemic began to return to their original land. In 1940 a new outbreak appeared in the area, and only in 1956 did resettlement, promoted by the government, begin again. The result of the epidemic was that southern Busaga, its most densely populated area, was virtually uninhabited. Other areas affected by sleeping sickness, including eastern Bukuli and Biziki, were depopulated as well. Famines also triggered substantial population movements. Parts of northeastern Busaga and the adjacent Bukandi district, across the Mpologoma River, experienced famines in 1907, 1908, 1917, 1918, 1898, 1900, 1907, 1908, 1917, 1918, and 1944. Populations in these areas shrank, many people were killed by the famines, and survivors moved to other areas for safety. The effects of these movements were apparent in the growth in population of central and peri-urban Busaga. Many Basoga left Busaga during this period for other districts. During the pre-colonial era, people left their traditional lands and state structures disappeared. A number of clans and chiefdoms were decimated by famine and epidemics, and people migrated to Busaga with the traditions and cultures of other lands. A need for security fueled population growth in urban and peri-urban areas of Busaga such as Jinjia, Iganga, Kamuli, Kalaro, and their surrounding areas. From 1920 to the 1970s, Jinjia, Busaga's capital, gained economic importance due to cotton production and the completion of the Uganda Railway and the Owen Falls Dam. The town became an agri-industrial center with factories, cottage industries, and a well-developed infrastructure. People from rural Busaga came to work in the factories and in domestic work. Among the newcomers were Asian families. Services such as piped water, electricity, roads, hospitals, and schools were improved to serve the growing population. Farmers were assured of markets in the towns, grew cash, and food crops such as cotton, coffee, bananas, potatoes, cassava, fruits and vegetables. The standard of living improved, the kingdom's revenue increased, enabling it to build more infrastructure. Subsistence farming diminished, with the population turning to economic production demanded by the Europeans. By the time of independence in 1962, Busaga was one of the most prosperous regions in Uganda. Jinjia was home to 70% of Uganda's industries and the Nalyabale Power Station, Owen Falls Dam, which supplies electricity to Uganda and parts of Kenya and Tanzania. Jinjia was also home to the majority of Uganda's Asian population. These Ugandan Asians, brought to Uganda from the Indian subcontinent by the British during the Raj, helped establish Jinjia as one of East Africa's largest commercial centers. Around the turn of the 16th century, the Bazangobi clan from Bunyoro gained power. Makama Namutukula of the royal Babiato family of Bunyoro is said to have left Bunyoro during the 16th century as part of the kingdom's expansion policy, traveling east across Lake Kiga with his wife Naudo, a few servants, arms, and a dog and landing at Iingo in northern Busaga, in the present-day Kamuli district. Makama, who enjoyed hunting, was taken with the land. He engaged in metalworking, blacksmithing and making hoes, iron utensils, and spears. Of Makama's children, 5 boys survived, and when he returned to Bunyoro, he gave them land to oversee. His firstborn, Wakali, received Bukuli, Zibondo received Bulamaji, and Gobi Kigulu, Tabingwelu Uka, and the youngest son, Kidimbo, received Bugabula. These areas later became administrative and cultural centers in Busaga. When Makama did not return, his sons regarded themselves as the legitimate rulers of their respective areas. They presided over their dominions, employing governing methods and cultural rituals similar to those in Bunyoro. This political and cultural arrangement in Busaga continued until the late 19th century, when the colonialists persuaded its rulers to organize a federation. The federation was governed by a lukako. Although Busaga is called a kingdom, it did not have a central ruler before 1906, unlike its western neighbor Buganda. In 1906, a central administrator, later a king, was installed at the behest of the British. Before this, the Basoga were organized in semi-autonomous chiefdoms influenced by Bunyoro and, later, Buganda. Some of the chiefs were appointed by the Kabaka, and, before the ascendancy of Buganda as the region's dominant power, by the Omukama of Bunyoro. Busaga's first native king was the chief of Bugabula, Yuzia Ndiope. Ndiope died in 1913 and was, in 1919, succeeded by the chief of Bulamaji, Ezekiel Teniwawako, who had both support of the colonialist British support and an administrative background, in addition to his being educated at the prestigious King's College Budo. Gideon Abadha of Kigulu, another contender for the post, was unfamiliar with the British system, and William Wilberforce Ndiope Kadhumbula of Bugabula was an infant whose regent, Mwami Mutkanga, was ineligible as a Mukupi, a commoner. In 1918-19, the title of Isibantu Kayabazinga was created and Wako took the throne. In 1925 Wako became a member of the Uganda King's Council, consisting of the Kayabazinga of Busaga, the Kabaka of Buganda, the Omukamas of Bunyoro and Toro, and the Omugabe of Ankole. On February 11, 1939, Oikatabwe Ezekiel Teniwa Wako, father of the last Kayabazinga of Busaga Henry Wako Maloki and the Zibondo of Bulamaji, was installed as the first Kayabazinga of Busaga, a title he held until his 1949 retirement. By Wako's retirement, the Lukako had expanded to include elected representatives, 2 from each of Busaga's 55 sub-counties. When Wako retired, the Busaga Lukako resolved that the Kayabazinga should be elected from the 5 lineages of Baze and Gobi, Ababiato, hereditary rulers traditionally believed to have been the 5 sons of the Omukama of Bunyoro who migrated to Busaga from Bunyoro. This method of election was used for subsequent elections, beginning in 1949 when Oikatabwe Chief William Wilberforce Ndiope Kadhumbula of Bugabula was elected. He served for 2 terms of 3 years each, followed by Henry Wako Maloki, who also served 2 terms. In 1957, the title Inhibantu of Busaga was introduced for the wife of the Kayabazinga, or Isibantu. When monarchies were abolished in 1966, the Kayabazinga was dethroned. Idi Amin expelled the Asians from Uganda in 1972, and Jinjia suffered socially and economically. The government of Yoweri Museveni has tried to encourage them to return. The Asian influence remains, particularly in architecture and street names. In 1995, the government restored monarchies in Uganda. On February 11, Henry Wako Maloki was reinstated as Kayabazinga according to Kisagan tradition. Unlike most monarchs, the Kayabazinga has no heir or crown prince but is succeeded by a chief elected by the Lukako and the Royal Council. 3 past Kayabazingas have presided over the federated state of Busaga since 1939, Ezekiel Teniwa Wako, Yuzia Ndiope, and William Wilberforce Ndiope Kadhumbula. Kadhumbula waged an Mizandila, war on theft, and ended a British practice in the fight against smallpox, Kaumpuli, where residents were required to publicly supply rat tails for counting to prove that they had killed the rats. His opposition brought him into conflict with the British, he was exiled to Bunyoro, later leading the Baisoga into the Second World War. Kadhambula played an important role in Uganda's independence struggle. He was also the first vice president of Independent Uganda and chairman of the Uganda People's Congress, UPC. Kadhambula built infrastructure such as roads, hospitals, and government centers, and mobilized the Baisoga for agriculture. Balangira High School later became Busaga College.
Oyagala omukulu gugwenja olugubire n'ebijukize mu nyumba yo kankwanjulire Backing Montage Photo Studio fiba kafulumu kuba bifananyi nokola video olina wedding birthday party kuchala nika baby shower photoshoot oba music shoot na buli kimu kyonna kyoyagala fe tusobola okuwa ebijukizo ebirungi eri ebirooto byo ate nno mwana watu kusintiza omuntu wa bulijjo tusange bonnankula bikubitaala ku Prime Tower level 3 room D04 okumanya ebisingawo tukubire ku namba zino note musavu note 2 emu note 4 emu 25 Oba, noti musavu tano tano, satu emuemu, musavu satu emu. Oba, noti musavu musavu musavu, noti biri satu, nyan noti tano. King Montage Photo Studio, fetu sabulo kuwe bijukize birungi. Ate nno mwana watu kusintiza omuntu wa bulijjo.